Nityanandam. Today, we offer the Pratyakshapada Puja at the Divine Lotus Feet of Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam. Before we begin the Pada Puja today, we request the Pada Puja participants who are physically here and online to declare the following with integrity and authenticity. If you agree to this, please say yes loudly. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth that cosmic energy exists. Yes. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth that His Divine Holiness Swamiji is the Chinmaya Vigraha, the embodiment and representation of that very cosmic energy. Yes. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth that whatever I offer during the Pada Puja to His Divine Holiness Swamiji will reach the cosmic source of energy directly. Yes. I authentically cognize, which is internally processed, understand and declare the truth of Sohamasmi, that even when I worship, I am Him. Yes. Let us now enter the Pratyakshapada Puja. Please be seated in a meditative space of gratitude and deep restful awareness in your Anandaganda. We will begin the puja with the Sadguru Vandanam. Now, please take some flowers in your hands, close your eyes, and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Nityanandam paramasukadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gagana sadrusham tattvamasyadilakshyam एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षीभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि.
The next offering is the Guru Parampara Vandanam. Now please take some flowers in your hands and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्.
The next offering is the Arunagiri Yogeshwara Vandanam. Now please take some flowers in your hands and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Lalate Tripundri Nitilakrita Kasturi Tilakaha Spuran Mala Dhara Spurita Katigopi Navasanaha Nadhano Dushtaram Shirasi Panirajam Shashikalam Pradipa Sarvesham Arunagiri Yogi Vijayate.
We will now perform Tattvachamanam, the ritualistic cleansing of the hands and the mouth. Now, with the right hand in the Gokarna Mudra, please take 3 sips of water as we chant the following 3 mantras.
Atma Dattvam Shodhaya Misvadha, Vidya Dattvam Shodhaya Misvadha, Shiva Dattvam Shodhaya Misvadha,
with the base of your right hand thumb, wipe your lips from right to left 2 times.
Umham Hridayaya Namaha.
With index, middle and ring finger of the right hand, touch the upper lip and lower lip. With the index finger and thumb of the right hand joined together, touch your right nostril, left nostril. With the ring finger and thumb joined together, touch your right eye, left eye, right ear and left ear. Wash your right hand again. And then with the little finger and thumb joined together, touch the navel, right chest, right side of the chest, left side of the chest. With all the tips of your fingers, touch the top of your head, right shoulder, left shoulder, and the center of your heart. We will now perform Shuklambaradharam. Now, please take some turmeric mixed rice in your right hand and clench both your hands in the Mushti Mudra. Tap the sides of your forehead 5 times as we chant the following mantra.
Shuklam Bharadaram Vishnum Shashivaranam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vignopashantayet.
We'll now perform Pranayama, the regulation of breathing. With the right hand thumb, close your right nostril and inhale through the left nostril. Hold both your nostrils closed with your ring and thumb and hold your breath, closing your left nostril with your ring finger. Exhale through the right nostril. As we do the 3 steps of pranayama, we'll be chanting the Samhita mantras for each of the steps.
Om Hom Ishana Murdaya Namaha, Om Hem Tat Purusha Vaktraya Namaha, Om Hum Gaurudayaya Namaha, Om Hem Vamadeva Gutyaya Namaha, Om Hum Satyajata Murtaya Namaha, Om Hamrudayaya Namaha, Om Heem Shirasaya Namaha, Om Hum Shikhaya Namaha, Om Hem Kavachaya Namaha, Om Hom Netrebhyo Namaha, Om Hastraya Namaha. Om Hom Ishana Murdaya Namaha, Om Hem Tat Purusha Vaktraya Namaha, Om Hum Gaurudayaya Namaha, Om Hem Vamadeva Gutyaya Namaha, Om Hum Satyajata Murtaya Namaha, Om Hamrudayaya Namaha, Om Heem Shirasaya Namaha, Om Hum Shikhaya Namaha, Om Hem Kavachaya Namaha, Om Hom Netrebhyo Namaha, Om Hastraya Namaha. Om Hom Ishana Murdaya Namaha, Om Hem Tat Purusha Vaktraya Namaha, Om Hum Gaurudayaya Namaha, Om Hem Vamadeva Gutyaya Namaha, Om Hum Satyajata Murtaya Namaha, Om Hamrudayaya Namaha, Om Heem Shirasaya Namaha, Om Hum Shikhaya Namaha, Om Hem Kavachaya Namaha, Om Hom Netrebhyo Namaha, Om Hastraya Namaha.
Next we'll chant the Sankalpa, the conscious resolution. Continue to hold the Akshata and the rice in your right hand. Clench your right hand in your left hand. Keep both your hands on your right thigh.
Mamopatta Samasta Duritakshaya Dvara Bhagavat Shri Nityananda Paramashiva Prityartham Shri Nityanandeshwari Parashakti Sameta Shri Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Prityartham Cha Shubhe Shobhane Muhurte Adhya Brahmanaha Dvitiya Parardhe Shri Sveta Varaha Kalpe Vaivasvata Manvantare Ashtavimshatitame Nitya Yuge Prathame Pade Jambudvipe Bharata Varshe Bharata Kande Meroho Dakshine Parshve Chakabde Asmin Vartamane Vyavaharike Prabhavadinam Shastyaha Samvatsaranam Madhye Vikarinama Samvatsare Dakshina Yene Shri Lakshmi Venkateshwar Ritao Dhanurmase Krishna Pakshe Dvitiyayam Shubhadito Bhanuvasara Yuktayam Pushyanakshatra Vishkambhayoga Kaitilakarana Evam Gunavisheshana Visishthayam
अस्याम शुभदितौ ओंकार टिकू नाम अधेयस्य शिवनारायण टिकू नाम अधेयस्य अंशु टिकू नाम याह अंजलि टिकू नाम याह अमरे टिकू नाम अधेयस्य रिया टिकू नाम याह न्याला ईशानी टिकू नाम याह सकुटुंबस्य सकुटुंबस्य च श्री कैलासोन्नत द्वादशांत श्यामला पीठारूढ श्री मीनाक्षी सुंदरेश्वरा भिन्न स्वरूप परशिवपुत्र रत्नकुमार गुरुमन्यतुल्यावतार श्री पार्वती स्थन्यपान लब्ध दिव्य ज्ञान विश्रुत सकल निगमागम सारभूत द्राविड वेद प्रवक्त्रे श्रीमत् परम शिव करुणा समधिगत मुक्तामय चतुरश्रियान गीयमान छत्र चामर श्री चिन्ह काहलादि समस्त बिरडा बिरदावल्यलंकृत ज्ञान विज्ञान चक्रवर्ती सर्वजन संग सद्यो निर्वाण दीक्षा व्ययापवर्ग विश्रान जीमूत परमत कलभ केसरी शैव सिद्धांत स्थापनाचार्य श्री राजादिराज पांड्य महाराज गुरु क्षपन शाख्यादि महांधकार निवारण ज्ञान भानु वीक्षणानर्हार्ह ध्वजोच्छेदन पूर्वक श्रीमद् वृषभ ध्वज स्थापक शैव समय कर्त्रे सर्वज्ञ पीठारूढ श्री जगद्गुरु श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक स्वामी वागीश सुंदर माणिक्य वाचक स्वामिनाम अवतार भूत श्री ज्ञान संबंध स्वामी पुनरुद्धृत श्यामला पीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रय त्रिणवत्युत्तर द्विशततम गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत आदि अरुणाचल सर्वज्ञ पीठ गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत आदिपीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ ध्यान पीठ मठ गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत कांची कैलास सर्वज्ञपीठ त्रयस्त्रिंशदुत्तर द्विशततम गुरु महासन्निधान साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कैलास परंपरागत वैवश्वतमनु इक्ष्वाकु हरिश्चंद्र भगीरथ श्रीरामचंद्र शूरसेन इत्यादि अनविच्छिन्न सार्वभौम चक्रवर्ती परंपरागत चतुष्षष्ठी योगिनी मंडित चतुष्षष्ठी संप्रदाय प्रवर्तक मनुधर्म शासन सूर्यवंश प्राप्त सर्वज्ञपीठ सुरांगी साम्राज्य मूर्धा भीक्षित चूड़ामणि महानिर्वाणी पीठ से अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री महामंडलेश्वर अटलपीठ से अष्टोत्तर सहस्रतम अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री अटलपीठाधीश्वर धर्म मुक्ति स्वर्गपुर स्वर्णपीठ से त्रयोविंश गुरु महासन्निधान श्रीमत् परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्यवर्य सच्चिदानंद प्रणव स्वरूप श्रोत्रिय ब्रह्मनिष्ठ नित्योत्सव नित्य मंगल नित्य कल्याण नित्य रजित नित्यानंद पीठ महासंस्थान महासिंहासन पीठ कर्त्रे कैलास पुनरुद्धारक श्री कैलास पुनरुद्धारक श्री कैलास परमाचार्य जगद्गुरु शील श्री भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामिनां प्रीत्यर्थं तेषां पादारविंदयोः भक्ति सिद्ध्यर्थं गुरुकृपा कटाक्ष सिद्ध्यर्थं क्षेमस्थैर्य वीर्य विजय आयुरारोग्य ऐश्वर्यानां अभिवृद्ध्यर्थं धर्मार्थ काम मोक्ष चतुर्विध फल पुरुषार्थ सिद्ध्यर्थं समस्त दुरितोपशान्त्यर्थं समस्त मंगलावाप्यर्थं भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परमशिव प्रसादेन सकुटुंबस्य ज्ञान वैराग्य जीवन मुक्ति प्राप्यर्थं श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति समेत श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिव अवतार भूत श्री सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूप भगवच्छ्री नित्यानंद परमशिव प्रत्यक्ष पाद पूजां च करिष्ये. Drop the akshata and flower on your right hand side and wash your right hand with the water. Apa upasprishya. Now from Ganthanada, please ring the bell with your left hand, ringing it loudly above your heart level.
Agamartantu devanam, gamanartantu rakshasam, Ganthanadam karom yado devata kwanalanchanam, Ganthadevata bhyo namaha.
We will now chant the Manasa Pujas mantras. Please take some flowers in your hands and hold your hands in the Kurma Mudra. Sit straight and close your eyes. Offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Om Hrit Padma Masanam Dadhyad Sahasrarachyutam Rutaihi Padyam Charanayor Dadhyad Manastu Argyam Nivedayet Tena Amrutena Achamaniyam Snaniyam Tena Chasmritam Akashatatvam Vastram Syat Gandhasyat Gandhatatvakam Chittam Prakalpayet Pushpam Dhupam Pranan Prakalpayet Tejastatvam Chadipartham Naivedyam Syat Sudam Budhihi Anahatadvanirgantha Vayutatvam Chachamaram Sahasraram Bhavet Chatram Shabdhatatvam Chagitakam Nrityam Indriya Karmani Chanchalyam Manasastatha Sumekalam Padmamalam Pushpam Nana Vidam Tata Amayadir Bhava Pushpaihi Achayet Bhava Gocharam Amayam Manahankaram Aragam Amadham Tata Amohakam Adambam Cha Advesha Akshobhakau Tata Amatsaryam Malopam Cha Dasabushpam Vidurbhutaha Ahimsa Paramam Pushpam Pushpam Indriya Nigraha Daya Pushpam Shama Pushpam Jnana Pushpam Chapanchamam Iti Panchadaser Bhava Pushpehi Sampujayet Bhagavantam Shri Nityananda Paramashivam.
We will now begin the Upachara Puja, the external worship. Now, the first offering is Asanam, the offering of the seat. Now, please take the Akshata and flowers in your hands and offer them at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Asanam Om Sarvabhutantarasthaya Sarvabhutantaratmane Kalpayam Nyupaveshartham Asanam Te Namo Namaha Om Hrim Idam Suvarnasanam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha.
The next offering is Swagatam, welcoming Swamiji. Now, please take some flowers in your hands and offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Swagatam Om Shantatvat Sarvakartritva Bhavo Paratikaranat Shivavukto Mahatantra Mantra Vidbisada Shivaha Tasmai Shivaya Gurave Vitaraga Kalayavai Amayatvatanantoyam Majatvacha Prakirtitaha Yasya Darshanamichanti Deva Swabhishta Siddhaye Tasmaite Parameshana Swagatam Swagatam Prabho Adhyame Saphalam Janma Jivanam Saphalakriyaha Swagatam Yatvayatanme Tapasam Phalamagatam Om Hrim Sarvadeva Devi Swarupa Bhagavan Shri Nityananda Paramashiva Swagatam Suswagatam Te.
The next offering is Padyam, the offering of water to wash the feet of His Divine Holiness Swamiji. Now please take some Padyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Padyam Om Yad Bhakti Lesha Samparkat Paramananda Samplavaha Tasmaite Parameshana Padyam Shuddhaya Kalpayet Om Hrim Etat Padyam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha.
The next offering is Argya, the offering of the traditional bouquet. Now please take the conch in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Argyaha Om Durvakshata Samayuktam Bilva Patram Tataparam Shobhanam Shankapatrastam Grahana Argyam Maheshwara. Om Hrim Esho Argyaha Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Swaha.
The next offering is Achamaniyam, the offering of water to wash the hands and the mouth. Now, please take the Achamaniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Achamaniyam Om Mandakinyastu Yadvari Sarvapapaharam Shubham Grahanachamaniyam Tvam Maya Bhaktya Niveditam Om Bhim Idam Achamaniyodakam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Swadha.
The next offering is Madhuparka, the offering of the nectarine drink. Now please take the cup of Madhuparka in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Madhuparkaha Om Sarvakalmashanashaya Paripurna Shudhatmakam Madhuparkamimam Deva Kalpayami Prasidame Om Hrim Esha Madhuparkaha Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Swadha.
The next offering is Gandhatailam, the offering of the scented oil. Now please take the Gandhatailam in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Gandhatailam Om Sneham Grahana Snehena Lokanam Hitakaraka Sarvalokeshu Shuddhastvam Dadami Snehamuttamam Om Hrim Idam Gandhatailam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Nivedayami.
The next offering is Snaniyam, the offering of the sacred bath. Now please take this Snaniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. And please ring the bell as you do so.
Snaniyam Om Idam Shushitalam Vari Swacham Shuddham Manoharam Snanartham Te Maya Bhaktya Kalpitam Pratigrihyatam Om Hrim Idam Snaniyodakam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Nivedayami.
The next offering is Vastram, the offering of clothing. Now please take the offering of clothing Vastram in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Vastram Om Maya Chitrapata Channa Nijaguhyoru Tejase Niravarana Vignaya Vasaste Kalpayam Nyaham Om Hrim Idam Vastottariyam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Nivedayami.
The next offering is Abharanam, the offering of the jewelry. Now please take the Abharanam in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Abharanam Om स्वभाव सुंदर अंगाय नाना शक्त्याश्रयायते सुवर्णं भूषणं तुभ्यं कल्पयामि प्रसीद मे ओम ह्रीं इदं सुवर्णाभरणं सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय निवेदयामि.
The next offering is the sandalwood paste, the offering of Gandha. Now please take the Gandha in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Gandha Om Shariram Tena Janami Cheshtam Naivacha Naivacha Maya Nivedita'an Gandha'an Pratigrihya Vilipyata'am ओम ह्रीम एष गंधः सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः.
The next offering is pushpam, the offering of the fragrant flowers. Now please take some flowers in your hands and smear them with sandalwood paste. Offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
पुष्पम् ओम तुरीयवनसंपन्नम् नाना गुणमनोहरम् आनंदसौरभम् पुष्पम् गृह्यताम् इदमुत्तमम् ओम ह्रीं एतानि सचंदनपुष्पाणि सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय वौषट्.
The next offering is Bilva Patram, the offering of the Bilva leaf. Now please take the Bilva leaf smeared with sandalwood paste in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Bilva Patram Om Amrutodbhavam Sri Vriksham Shankarasya Sada Priyam Bilva Patram Prayachami Pavitram Te Sureshwara ओम ह्रीम एतानि सचंदन बिल्ववत्राणि सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय भौषट.
The next offering is Tulasi Patram, the offering of the Tulasi leaf. Now please take the Tulasi leaf made with sandalwood paste in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
तुलसी पत्रम् ओम नमस्ते बहुरूपाय वरदमूर्तये परमात्मने स्वाहा ओम ह्रीं इदं सचंदन तुलसी पत्रम् सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः.
The next offering is dhupa, the offering of the lit incense. Now please take the dhupa in your hands and slowly wave it towards His Divine Holiness Swamiji along with the mantra. Please ring the bell as you do so.
Dhupaha Om Vanaspati Raso Divyo Gandhadya Sumanoharaha Agreya Sarvadevanam Dhupoyam Pratigrihyatam ओम ह्रीम एष धूपः सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः.
The next offering is Deepa, the offering of the lit lamp. Now please take the lit Deepa in your hands and slowly wave it towards His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
दीपाः ओम सुप्रकाशो महादीपः सर्वतस्तिमिरापहः सबाख्याभ्यंतर ज्योतिर्दीपोयं प्रतिगृह्यताम् ओम ह्रीं एष दीपः सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः.
The next offering is Naivedyam, the offering of food. Now please take some Naivedyam in your hands and take the Udharini of water, hover it clockwise around the Naivedyam and offer the water at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra. Please ring the bell as you do so.
Naivedyam Om. Naivedyam vivitam deva shakkaradi vinirmitam maya niveditam bhaktya grahana parameshwara Om Hrim idam sopakarna naivedyam sarvadeva devi swarupaya bhagavate shri nityananda paramashivaya namaha.
The next offering is Pavaniyam, the offering of drinking water. Now, please take the Paniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet along with the mantra.
Paniyam Om Samasta Deva Devesha Sarva Triptikaram Param Akhandananda Sampurnam Grahana Jalamuttamam Om Hrim Idam Panarthodakam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha.
The next offering is Punarachamaniyam, the offering of water to wash the hands and the mouth. Now, please take the Punarachamaniyam water in your hands and offer it at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet at the end of the mantra.
Punarachamaniyam Om Uchishtamapya Suchirva Yasya Smaranamatrataha Shuddhimapnoti Dasmaite Punarachamaniyakam Om Hrim Idam Punarachamaniyodakam Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Swaha.
The next offering is Aratrikam, the offering of Aarti. Now please take the lit Aarti lamp in your hands and slowly wave towards His Divine Holiness Swamiji along with the mantra, and please ring the bell as you do so.
Aratrikam Om Hrim Esha Deepa Mala Sarvadeva Devi Swarupaya Bhagavate Shri Nityananda Paramashivaya Namaha. Om Rajadi Rajaya Prasanya Zahine Namo Vayam Vai Eshravanaya Gurmahe Sameka Man Kama Kama Yamakhyo Kameshwaro Vai Ishravano Dhadato Kuberaya Vaishravanaya Maharajaya Namaha. Karpura Gauram Karunavataram Samsarasaram Bhujagendraharam Sadavasantam Hridayaravinde Bhavam Bhavani Sahitam Namami Bhavam Bhavani Sahitam Namami Bhavam Bhavani Sahitam Namami. Aradrigam samarpayami Bhagavat Shri Nityananda Paramashiva Charana Kamalebhyo Namaha.
The next offering is Pushpanjali, the offering of flowers. Please take some flowers in your hands and hold your hands in the Atmanjali Mudra. Offer the flowers at His Divine Holiness Swamiji's feet, the end of the mantra.
Pushpanjalihi Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnuho Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Akhanda Mandala Karam Vyaptam Yena Characharam Tatpadam Darshitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. अनेक जन्म संप्राप्त कर्म बंध विदाहिने आत्मज्ञान प्रदानेन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। मन्नाथ श्री जगन्नाथो मद्गुरु श्री जगद्गुरुः मम आत्मा सर्वभूतात्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरापनेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। नित्यानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वदी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। पुष्पाञ्जलिं समर्पयामि भगवच्छ्री नित्यानन्द परमशिवचरणकमलेभ्यो नमः। ॐ नित्यानन्दम्
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
Kailasa TV, Hinduism Now TV, YouTube Live, Facebook Live, Twitter Live, and through Enlighten app. Once again, welcoming all of you for this segment of Morning Satsang. So, Kailasa TV, Hinduism. Every day we are seeing that Swamiji is... Sorry for the technical glitch. As we are seeing, every single day, Swamiji is sharing a very powerful cognition. Powerful cognition. Swamiji said, it is something which we need to internalize. Powerful cognitions are, once we cognize the powerful cognitions, then we realize that actually Paramashiva is real. Powerful cognition has to be lived every single moment. Three powerful cognitions Swamiji shared with all of us. The first is that Paramashiva is real. Means what we understand with God. God is the one who creates, who maintains, who pulls you out of the delusion and who liberates. The one who does all this is real. Second, Paramashiva is inside us. He is real. He is manifesting through this body. When you recognize this, that Paramashiva is real and he is manifesting through you, you start achieving the state, the Paramashiva's state, space, his powers, superconscious being, and Sri Kailasa itself. It is nothing but Paramashiva himself realizing you, first making you understand that he exists. Second, he is giving you the experience, the very experience of him by manifesting through you. The moment you get this cognition, yes, Paramashiva is real. He is manifesting to me. Then you start achieving his own state, space, his powers, his super conscious being, and Sri Kailasa itself. With this powerful cognition, when you just start your day from the beginning to the end, if you keep these cognitions, just understand that life will be, literally Swamiji is taking us to the highest conscious level. Because what we think about ourselves, it's so shallow and so small that it takes so much time for us to even realize that Paramashiva is real. That super conscious being is, like Swamiji says, that you are not a human being who is experiencing this super consciousness or spiritual being. You are a spiritual being experiencing this human body. Means we are Paramashiva and we are only experiencing, we have this Paramashiva, the divine expression of us, is just come down to experience this human body. It has a big difference. That is why Swamiji says that what you think about yourself doesn't matter. What matters is what you cognize about yourself. Are you cognizing yourself as a human being? Or you're cognizing yourself as Paramashiva? Then the way you manifest life will just change. Because when you operate from the state, space and powers, the super conscious being of Paramashiva, you will know you can manifest anything what he is manifesting. What you dream about it, you know it is you. Paramashiva is inside you and ready to manifest through you. Every single moment, let's start living with these cognitions, which will just turn the whole life around you. Swamiji said we should hear these powerful cognitions again and again and again until it becomes your default cognition and you achieve enlightenment. We need to remind ourselves again and again that yes, we are Paramashiva. Along with this, one of the very beautiful tradition, I can say the ritual which happened yesterday and still the second batch has also started around the world, Diksha into Power Manifestation. The first level Diksha as per Sanatan Hindu Dharma, Swamiji gave the Diksha to all the participants around the world and initiated all the participants into three powerful cognitions. By giving the Diksha, the first thing Swamiji gave is Charyapada, giving Diksha into Charyapada, which is Puja. Kriyapada, which is Nityananda Yoga, Yoga Pada. Swamiji gave Diksha into Nityananda Yoga. And third, Jnanapada means giving Diksha for power manifestation. These three things are enough for everything, whatever is happening around you. You are just set for everything. These three padas, Charyapada, Kriyapada, Jnanapada. All three powerful cognitions. When you just cognize and start living, you will see, you will have a tremendous powerfulness. The way we have seen Swamiji, no matter what happens, the moment Swamiji speaks, it's Paramashiva who is talking, who is speaking. We'll experience the same space state and the superconscious being of Paramashiva. Like this, Swamiji has given Diksha and raised all of us in these powerful cognitions, day and night. I can say all the sannyasis, all the devotees, all the disciples have experienced this, the way Swamiji raises all of us. Every single moment, any situation comes, the way Swamiji manifests the powerful cognition and raises from the situation, raises from that particular cognition which we are carrying about ourselves, about life, about people, to share such experience, to share such cognition, the shift, the cognitive shift which has happened in all of our life. Today I have requested one of my co-sannyasi to come and share her experiences, to share from what life she was experiencing before coming to Swamiji and how the whole changes, the way now she is experiencing life, the kind of transformation happened in her. It's like I can say before and after, how life has taken a turn the moment Swamiji happened in her life. She becoming the channel for crores of people to give them the similar experience what she has achieved, what she is able to cognize, what she is able to get. She has now, she is becoming the channel for people to experience the same. So I have my co-sanyasi, Maniti Amritamayananda, to share her experiences with all of us. I would like to request Ma Amritamaya to come forward and share her experiences. Ma Amritamaya, Nityanandam.
Nityanandam, everyone. Nityanandam, all the viewers. Yes, so originally I'm from Melbourne, Australia. And pretty much a bit of a background of me. I had a really, you know, clear career path in one of Australia's leading banks in the business sector. You know, I had a very fulfilling, wholesome social life, lots of friends, very outgoing, you know, every weekend there'd be something on. And I have a brother and a mother and a very loving family, and everything was fine and dandy. But, you know, there was always that feeling that I was not living in a way that I was feeling fulfilled, pretty much. And I would say that I had been, you know, seeking or very spiritually inclined for a very long time, and always curiously asking, you know, the existential questions, you know, the big questions like, what is the purpose of life? What are we doing here? You know, I had everything I wanted. You know, I had the luxuries. I had, you know, enough money to sustain my desires and what I wanted to do, you know, holidays and traveling and, you know, all the basic things that we set as our goals. But yes, it wasn't until, you know, I discovered, Swamiji discovered me pretty much back in 2018 when my journey with, you know, the Sangha started. That's when I really felt I found the answer. So it started with Nityananda Yoga program. I'm currently ordained as a Nityananda Yoga Acharya. And that was the starting point of me experiencing the sense and space of leadership for others. You know, having those initial breakthroughs with being able to hold space for, you know, more than 50, 60 people at a time, and getting that sense that I have the ability to lead others into also becoming leaders for other people. And that space of leadership and integrity and authenticity that I have now grounded in myself through, you know, the guidance and the nurturing and everything that Swamiji has provided me up until this point. So, yeah.
Would you, Maya Amritamaya, would you like to share like some specific incidences like you, where you have seen kind of like, I can say, a miraculous experience, like you were not expecting something and then you found out like this is something wow, something where you felt like Swamiji's direct presence happened, and you know, like it was just him who just came and give you that experience. Yes.
I would have to say by far the most significant breakthrough that I've had as being a Brahmacharini as well is the change that I'm seeing in my family as well, that sense of trust that I am now in a good place. Whereas before, you know, I was confused and my mom would always be worried about me. And, you know, people were generally worried about me because they saw that I was pretty much on a life of path of destruction, like very unhappy, very depressed, and, you know, very successful in my career and everything like this and social life. But deep down, you could definitely tell that I was like a depressed person. That just, you know, my mother seeing my transformation and seeing that I'm now stable and confident and mature enough to look after myself, and she trusts that I know what I'm doing now, it gives her that sense of security, and she can now do the things and not have to worry about me. And that brings me so much fulfillment, you know, knowing that my mom is now able to do the things that she wants to do without having that worry about me, you know. So that's one of the
So would you like to tell like exactly what kind of lifestyle you have lived like before coming to Swamiji, like exactly how what was your lifestyle like, what you used to do, and your friends and your like everything, how is it?
I will say that, you know, very outgoing, parties and, you know, yeah, pretty much going out, you know, alcoholism, all these type of thing that the youth of today is pretty much using as a band-aid to cover up that sense of discontentment that we have in life, you know, always drinking, always going to parties, always being out with the crowd and trying to fit in, trying to feel like a part of something, like a sense of belonging, and being influenced by one another and just to feel, yeah, that sense of community and sense of oneness with one another, but in a completely wrong way, you know. And so now the life that I have here, especially having sister monks that we all share that ideology of life, you know, building Sri Kailasa and building this community, a spiritually based community with one another, and having that support in a positive way rather than a self-destructive way is just what's most important for me now, is just having that that sense of direction in my life and not just being directionless, you know, and being a positive influence rather than just following the crowd. So that's
so
very important. Yeah.
So now after taking sannyas and, you know, getting diksha from Swamiji, you have experienced a life where you are becoming a channel for people to get the similar experience. Like you have been the one person and still you are doing that. So what do you want to tell about, like, some experiences which you had with people and the way people have experienced it, Swamiji's presence and the changes in their life? So anything about, would you like to share about it?
Yes, ma. So definitely being like a pure medium for, you know, super consciousness, for Swamiji to radiate through me, and the powers of the third eye as well, having that diksha of an awakened third eye and Kundalini awakening, all of this, having the ability to give people solutions for serious life problems, you know, having very basic, simple solutions through the scanning of, you know, the third eye, body scanning, mind reading, all these chakras that we've been initiated into, just having that as a tool in my bag to help other people, that is, it's priceless, you know. Like, I have the confidence that I can help anyone from any background, any, you know, any religion, anything like this. I have the ability and confidence to be able to give them solutions for their life and turn it right around. So the things that I had been experiencing, like, you know, depression and like all these, you know, mental health issues, and even physical health issues as well. Swamiji's initiation and giving us the ability to give people solutions is one of the best things that we can give to the world. And, you know, Swamiji always reiterates that life is for others. And it wasn't until that I fully aligned to this space where I could dedicate my life to helping others that I feel that sense of true fulfillment. And my purpose, I'm living my purpose now. I'm not just, you know, yeah, living life directionless. Wow.
That's so wonderful, Ma.
Yeah.
Before we conclude, would you like to have a message for all the viewers, those who are watching you live right now?
Yes. I guess especially for those who are confused and, you know, are looking for an answer, because right now, you know, in the modern day world, the education system and all of this, all that we've been conditioned to believe should be our life path, you know, having children, growing up, buying a house, going to school, getting a degree. Yes, that's all fine and dandy, but there is an answer beyond that. There is a spiritual solution. There is a bigger picture, and life is very auspicious when you align to, you know, the bigger picture, why we are here, why we are actually existing, you know. Having the courage to look in and ask yourself, what am I doing with my life? Am I really happy, or am I just following what society tells me I should be happy with? And really having the courage to say, no, that's not okay. It's time for me to really step it up and take responsibility for myself and other people and be a leader. That's one of the biggest messages I wanted to share with everyone. So.
Thank you, Amritamaya. It was really nice hearing from you. Yes, we are living together and we have a really, really wonderful life with Swamiji, and that very evidently we all can see. So thank you for sharing. It was really nice having you on the NTV panel. So thank you so much, Ma.
Thank you, everyone.
As you all heard, Ma Amritamaya, it was such an amazing, such a sweet sharing, like somebody who was having a lifestyle with partying, alcohol, like everything, all night parties, all full on alcohol. And now she is living such a great life, living the lifestyle of brahmacharya, having sattvic food, constantly making herself available for people to give them the powerful cognitions which Swamiji has shared and Swamiji has been sharing with all of us. Becoming the channel, being a person who is being a sannyasi, being Swamiji's channel, I myself has experienced. And it's just such a sweet feeling when you are able to become a channel for a person to get the breakthrough. When you manifest Paramashiva and give that glimpse to the other person, that's such a sweet feeling anybody can have in life when you know that Paramashiva is manifesting through you to help people around, giving them the right cognition and a breakthrough in life. To share this experience, of course, I'm having one of my another course sannyasi with me on the NTV panel today, Maniti Kailasananda, who also has experienced extraordinary changes in her life, and she becoming the channel for people to give the similar experiences. So without a delay, I would like to request Ma Kailasa to come forward and share her experiences, her journey with Swamiji. So Ma Kailasa, thank you, Nitin. Please share, Ma.
Yes, Ma. Nityanandam. This is Ma Nitya Kailasananda. So originally, I was born in a traditional Chinese family, with both of my parents being non-spiritual, non-religious. So I grew up actually eating meat whole time. I never imagined myself becoming religious or even spiritual was out of the question. So when I met Swamiji in 2017, I was actually in Sweden. At that time, I could say I was on top of my life. Actually, of course, I had in my life, I had a period where I felt very low, very lost. But at the moment I met Swamiji, actually, that time I was really engaged in different things. I had a job as an engineer in an engineering company. I was actually a buyer. And it was a decent job for a young lady living in the in Stockholm. I was in Stockholm, in a big city, the capital city of Sweden. So, and I had my apartment, my my life as per the standard in the Western society was decent. At least I had my own economy to support my travels during my free time. And in Sweden, you get many 4 or 5 weeks holidays during the year. So at that time also I felt so restless. So I worked in the gym as a trainer, and also even right before I met Swamiji, actually I started my own company. So if I think back at that time, I always felt empty inside. So that was probably why I engaged myself into so many different activities and things, and trying to find the meaning of life and trying to figure out who I really am and what I really want to do in my life. So actually when I received this call to share my story, I felt blank initially. I didn't know what I can share with everybody, like, because the growth and the change in my life is just too much to describe in a few minutes. So actually I shared a Facebook post 2 days ago, described how this change happened. I thought from I was little, I always asked myself who I would become and where I will end up and what I would be doing when I'm old, when I'm adult. And out of all the answers I would never imagine myself turning Hindu and being a proud disciple of Paramahansa, the ultimate embodiment of Paramahansa on planet Earth. So it's one out of nowhere. I couldn't really imagine that happened to my life. But when I realized this, I just dropped all the questionings and imaginations and started to accept life being too sweet. So deeply in my heart, since I was little, I always felt I wanted to do something good for the humanity, even if I was caught by fear and greed like everybody else, our patterns. So whatever I was doing was not really making sense, aside from the fact I was doing a lot of things. So I was living in a big lie. And the moment I realized Swamiji is a real master, I just dropped everything and decided to become a Brahmachari Sannyasi and live a style to enlightenment. At that time, I didn't understand what enlightenment is. I just know that he knows life better than me. I don't want to waste my life outside in a lie anymore. I just want to spend my time doing something real. And if he knows better than me, let me follow him. So during the past 2 years since I met Swamiji, I was doing enriching and causing work. I was part of the causing team. I realized whatever I wanted in life, all my desires were so fantastically fulfilled by the master. I always felt I want to contribute in something, and by sharing his teachings, I felt people being so connected with him, with divine, and I see their life changed. So many Chinese-speaking people, they got connected to Swamiji, and without my imagination, my ability of fantasy, I never thought so many people could be connected just because I started my YouTube channel and followed Guru Wat. That time, he asked the Adinawasis to make 3 videos a day, aside from all the language barriers and everything, and I felt I didn't know his teaching enough. I followed whatever he asked. And through this channel, I think more than right now, there are 6,000 subscribers. So many places the Sangha started since the YouTube channel was launched. So during the past 2 years, we had new Sangha happen in Taiwan, and a stronger force happened in Hong Kong and Singapore, Malaysia, and even new places like Japan. We have a center now and by Chinese devotees, and Australia, New Zealand, Europe, different countries, and North America. So it's literally a miracle, fantasy. I never thought it could happen like this, just by the grace of Swamiji. So how much he fulfilled my desire. So every day I felt, what did I do before to desire to deserve a life like this? Every second.
Ma, kela sir. Sorry to interrupt, Ma, but I really want you to share, like, your upbringing, the way the your religion, and then how you have, you know, the from the background, the family background you have come from, and from that to this, the change which has happened. And of course, as you all, as you shared, that how Chinese are connecting with Swamiji and they are experiencing real-time breakthroughs in life. And of course, you are becoming the channel of Swamiji. So I would like to like you to share, like, the kind of upbringing you have before coming to Swamiji, and the way you have lived your life, and the entire Chinese community, the faith, the religion, and everything. So we can see the amount of transformation which has really has happened. So would you like to share, Ma?
Yes. So just put it simply, the power of truth is universal. It doesn't matter which cultural background you are from or what religion you are from. People are like, we are all consciousness, we are drawn to the truth. So that's maybe why even the Chinese community grow like today, so blooming. me without even many people, even they don't know English language. Just by that little material we have available nowadays in the Chinese language, they can be so deeply connected to Swamiji. Our culture, I would say it's still very different from the Hindu culture. The first time I remember, I saw Swamiji's video on YouTube. I couldn't really connect with him. Sitting on the golden throne and speaking about enlightenment. From both my Eastern and my Western experience, Hindu culture is really something new. For Chinese, to study in school is the most important thing. I think the whole world understands the Taoism and also the Confucius, his philosophy. You have to obey, you have to study well, you have to serve the society with integrity and stuff. So to study in school, to do good at work, everything like that, and to have a family once you graduate from school. Before that, you cannot have any romantic relationship, and after the school, you immediately have to get married and have 10 children like that. So that's the culture from China, the Chinese world. And religion was never part of the culture. Actually, I think from the beginning of the history I know about China, the emperors, the kings, they always kept religion away from the mainstream culture. So even today, even if Buddhism and Taoism exist in China, most people are not religious. So for me, for most of the Chinese people, it is really new for us to be religious, I would say. In some Chinese regions, like for example, in Taiwan, Malaysia, Singapore, they get access to religion. But in quite many places, and even the family, the Chinese family, is not a common thing for them to practice any religion, actually. But because I feel Swamiji's word just penetrated your soul, whoever that intensely want to understand the meaning of life, they just get connected so simply, so easily. And after that, people start to accept the culture itself. So nowadays we promote puja, we teach people, Chinese people, to do puja and tell them how to tie sari and dhoti when they come to the diksha initiation during the weekend. And I was told that actually one of the Chinese adinam, in Singapore, was the most integrated with dressing, the dress code. So all of them also integrated with coming in white and traditional. And also the food, the Sedgwick food. People are so integrated with doing yoga and doing puja. So in the Asian time zone, we have actually every morning, Brahma Mahuta time, our Acharya Hansen hosting the yoga and puja time. So I know every day sincere devotees are attending this. So they're actually a good example for even the Adina Vasis. So integrated.
Wow. Lifestyle. I mean, that is really amazing from, like, as you shared, that not having any religion and then following a religion, you know, literally adopting an entire new culture. Of course, I can understand, like, being Indian, we have seen such kind of culture. We have seen, we have lived in the temples, temple-based lifestyle. Of course, not up to the extent that Swamiji has actually brought us in our life. But somebody who is, you know, completely out of the box, those who have not seen at all, and then after that experiencing this life, not only you experiencing, but you are becoming a channel. You are becoming that source. Somewhere you are connecting more and more people to have that experience. So one more thing before we move ahead, like I wanted to ask you, like, when you share your experiences with more and more Chinese people, and what kind of breakthroughs they had, like, you know, what you can admire, like you can see that how Swamiji has literally gone there and, you know, does the job for them. So would you like to share some of like examples or something, some sharings from them?
there are simply too many. People feel that they are nobody. They have they run centers nowadays, and they host Zoom sessions. So the speed of growth is just so amazing by listening to Swamiji's teachings and by applying his powerful cognitions in their daily lives. And Mahavakya chanting, for example, I have devotees sharing, they chant Mahavakya every day. It doesn't matter what they need. They want the traffic light to turn green. They want a taxi. They want to find a nice restaurant on the street. So immediately when they start chanting Mahavakya, all those miracles just being fulfilled. Simple things like this, two big things. People manifest wealth, health, and their family got healed. The relationship healed just because they started to follow Swamiji. They felt usually the family used to be so chaotic. The relationship amongst the different generations were really difficult. But just she attended Parama Shivoham. After the program, she described, just by being in that space, the whole family became so peaceful and harmonious. So no fight, no quarrel after that. And because of her following Swamiji, so many other members in the family, they started also to listen to Swamiji satsang and even reading his books. And his family business goes up so much. And she's actually one of the lead that put the most time in the Sangha work. So basically she doesn't have time for the business, I feel. But the business goes up by itself.
That's like, I can say, there are tons and tons of experiences like that and many incidences. Like if we start sharing, as you said, that there are simply so many. Each and every person has tons, like the way they are experiencing breakthroughs in their life by either by chanting the Mahavakya or doing the puja or doing the yoga, and especially the healing experiences they are going through. It's simply too many. I completely agree with you. Just before we could conclude, I would like to have you, like, just what you would like to tell the viewers today, those who are watching you live right now, what message you have for them?
Yes. Just by simply follow the truth, by listening to Swamiji satsang and applying his teachings in your daily life, you will experience the change, drastic change, miraculous change. Don't drop any hope. There's still hope on the planet Earth, and it's not even, I can't even put it as a hope. It's literally too sweet to be true. Life is too sweet with Swamiji on planet Earth. So whoever is watching this program, we are the most lucky person. So just be integrity with his teachings and apply it in your daily life. Start causing and enriching other people. You will experience miracle. I know how much my life is also changed as a person by doing enriching and causing work. By sharing his teaching, I literally dropped so many patterns and all the SDHDs. Only during 2 years' time, I know as a person how much I grew. And also, of course, as a causer, I want to take this chance to tell there are a lot of volunteer opportunities amongst the Chinese Sangha. We need translators. We need people who can spend some time for delivering the work. So whoever that watches this NTV live show, and if you're interested, please send email to the contact@kailasa.org. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ma. Thank you for this wonderful sharing from you. And as you have requested, of course, this platform is for that. Those who are watching us live, and if you know the Chinese, and if you know the Chinese language, and you wanted to be part of Sri Kailasa, then you can connect with us, which is contact@kailasa.org, and Ma Kailasa will be there to help you out and to assist you. So thank you, Ma, and thank you, Amrita. It was really nice having you both on NTV panel today. I can say, if I get each every single Adinavasi, it's going to be something very, very amazing, because every person has gone through a real roller coaster ride, I can say. Right from a person from a different culture, from a different religion, from a different place altogether, and then coming to this space where Swamiji has created this enlightened ecosystem. Sri Kailasa, the space of enlightened ecosystem where Swamiji is reviving the enlightened civilization. And all of us are the Sakshi Pramanas. Like, if I have to share my own life, being born in a Brahmin family, but I was never a person who will follow really religion or loving to go to temples or doing puja, or it was no way connected. The way my schooling is being done, the kind of lifestyle I have lived. Of course, my family is very traditional. But what the life which I was experiencing and I wanted to have, it was the idea about life, following your religion, following Hinduism, it's something gives you, I can say, you know, you feel like you are not modern. Like, if you're going to the temple and if you're sharing this with your friends, it's like, oh, you're so old-fashioned. You know, the idea of life was like this. So having fun outside, being with the friends and not doing pujas and, you know, following that Western culture, that was the idea of life which I used to have. And somebody who is like, from the software background and software engineering to fashion designing, it is a complete different life altogether, where there was, I cannot even imagine that I'll be a sannyasi. I have never had that thought. For me, sannyasi is something very old fashioned and which I don't want to have. Being in this modern life, being with my friends, I want to experience a different life. But just one experience, because ultimately all our consciousness want to attain the enlightenment. We all have come only to experience that, but we don't know how to do it. We don't know how we can have it. We don't know what is a path, and we feel that it is no more to be lived, and or maybe this is something not in trend today, especially for the youngsters I'm talking. In our school, in our college, we have certain idea about life. We don't understand the very lifestyle of Hinduism, the very lifestyle that Swamiji is giving to all of us. It's the most, the best, the most trendy lifestyle, I can say. Trend is not something which comes by what you wear or where you hang out. It is what you experience. The latest trend is what you experience, what you cognize about yourself, how the level of experience which you have about yourself, the highest cognition about yourself, because that is how you can manifest your life. But outside, the major problem is what people think about you. That's the major issue. That is the lowest cognition we carry, and we try to make everybody happy. But we forget that there is a consciousness inside you, which you have to realize that consciousness is nothing but Paramashiva himself sitting and ready to manifest. That will be the highest cognition, that will be the ultimate reality. When you wake up to that, you will have the bestest experiences in life wherever you are around the world. So the latest trend is not what you project to people or what people think about you. What you cognize about you is the latest trend. Stop following. Let's become our own boss. And this is what Swamiji is doing to us. This is what Swamiji is making us realize, that we are our own boss. So intelligence is not following something or trying to make somebody happy. I'm not saying hurt people. But have the powerful cognition that you are Paramashiva. You are that highest superconscious being. And start manifesting life the way Paramashiva is manifesting. So with this powerful cognition, before we go ahead to receive Swamiji, I would like to request everybody, share this live stream to all your friends and family, so that all of them can have this powerful cognition and everybody can lead a very great and powerful life. So quickly share with everybody, and with that, let us all chant the Mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. With this powerful state, let us enter into that meditative space of Sri Kailasa and receive Swamiji. Let's have a divine darshan followed by Nityananda Satsang. So for now, we'll see you tomorrow once again at the same time, 7 a.m. IST. For now, let's enter into the meditation and receive Swamiji. Thank you, Nityananda. All the viewers, after having this Atmalinga Mandala process, such an intense initiation Deeksha with Swamiji has given to all of us. One thing which Swamiji shared in the satsang, Swamiji told all of us, which we must do to understand the multi-dimensional logic, where E is not equal to MC square. We all had the question that how it is possible, right? Swamiji said that to have that understanding on it, you must read the article. There was one article which Swamiji asked all of us to read. I would like to request NTV operator to project that article for all of you with the link which all of us must read to understand the multi-dimensional logic of how E is not equals to MC square. And the article name is Impossibly Massive Black Hole LB1. So as you can see on the screen, all of you must read that. Apart from this, if you feel like that you have any questions on it and you wanted to know more details about it, we would request all of you. We'll be very happy to receive questions from you and any feedback or any kind of understanding which you wanted to have. Then I would request all of you to send your feedback, reviews, your questions to contact@kailasa.org and to have further more Vakyarth Sadas and to know more details, we would be very happy to receive. Once again, would like to remind all the viewers, on the upcoming weekend, there is a Diksha which is happening, Diksha into power manifestation. And as today all of us, we received the part of Diksha today, we received initiation from Swamiji. The Atmalinga Mandala process happened just now. Next weekend also we have opportunity to attend this program where Swamiji is literally going to take us to that multi-dimensional logic, the Paramashanta Swarupa, means the absolute oneness. The absolute oneness with your own highest existence, which is Paramashiva himself. So must sign up for the program, which is Diksha into Power Manifestation, where Swamiji himself is going to give Diksha to all the people around the world. You don't need to understand anywhere, wherever we have a temple, Adinam, any center, you can reach out to any nearest center, temple, Adinam, and attend this program. So must sign up for yourself, for your friends and family. And to understand the further details of multidimensional logic which Swamiji was explaining today, don't miss the satsangs. Because the revelation which Swamiji has done and continue to do it, it is something which needs to be understood again and again. We need to hear this again and again. We need to go through the details again and again to realize that what Paramashiva has revealed, it is still not cognized here. And why Swamiji is revealing is, so all the scientists, the sincere scientists, they need a base, they need a foundation to do further more research. And hence Swamiji is revealing these cosmic truths. And we are fortunate enough we are available here, we all are here to hear those truths directly from Swamiji. So let us not miss the opportunity to listen to these truths as it is when Swamiji is revealing. So don't miss the satsang, which is 8 a.m. IST, right on the same channel which you are watching right now. We'll be very happy to see all of you once again tomorrow. And after this Atmalingam Mandala process, when Swamiji has created that state, the space, the super conscious being which is being awakened by Swamiji, where Swamiji has raised our Kundalini Shakti to match the frequency to achieve Paramashiva, now it's time to manifest powers like Paramashiva. So don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. Let us all start the power manifestation. Immediate expression, Sakshi Praman, of you being Paramashiva. When you start manifesting, that's a Sakshi Pramana, that's a physical expression which you are seeing that you are Paramashiva. So let us all get ready to start the power manifestation. So stay tuned, don't go anywhere, and I'll be joining you again tomorrow at the same time, same channel, don't miss. And let's see you all tomorrow, 7 a.m. IST, in the same channel. And thank you so much. Thank you for watching. Nityananda. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Shivoham. Om.
with the Svanam. Let's sit straight. Visualize Bhagavan in the third eye and start with the Sadguru Vandanam. Nityanandam Paramasukadam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gagnasadusham Tattvamasya Vilakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshibhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Nityanandam, welcome to Kailash Kotiyar, Sri Kailash Kotiyar Manifesting Past Session. Welcome everybody. Swamiji has given a very powerful cognition today, connecting the five actions of Parameshiva, connecting the five, he calls it great truth of Parameshiva, and the Charya Pada, Yoga Pada, Kriya Pada, and how we can start and then Yes. Here today we are going to be manifesting the power of consciousness over matter, increasing the temperature of the liquid. Beautifully, Swamiji said, everything is manifested once we declare the enlightenment. Once we start understanding, everything happens. More and more we understand Paramashiva is manifesting, whether we are talking, whether we are deciding, whether we are walking, whether we are doing everything. The more of him, the less of us inside us. The Charya Pada, Kriya Pada, Yoga Pada and Jnana Pada again and again brings us to the ultimate, that Paramashiva made one to many. The pure space, zero, became many infinitely. And each one infinite powers and infinite intelligence. Each Brahman, he is waiting to celebrate that each one of us experiencing that infinity in us. And more we start experiencing Paramashiva Swamiji in us. Swamiji manifesting through us. Swamiji thinking through us. Swamiji deciding through us. Swamiji eating through us. More and more we understand Swamiji is happening through us. The less and less we are in there. And more celebration starts. More and more enlightenment, more and more ecstasy, bliss, everything starts. Today with the beautiful context, very powerful context. And here Swamiji is giving us the increase of temperature of liquid. So you can have... If you have a thermometer, excellent. Or you can have a glass of water. If you don't have thermometer, you can have two glasses of water and you can work with one and see the differences in the water or any other liquid. You can now sit straight. Visualize Bhagwan in the third eye. And connect to Swamiji in the oneness. That everything is Swamiji, whether you're talking, walking, speak, anything that happens through you. It is so beautiful that the whole happening through you is experienced through you more and more. The bliss and ecstasy just flows in us. So connect with the great revelation that Swamiji has given today about this zero and infinity, how the pure space of Paramashiva became many and infinity, and how each of us infinitely possible and celebrating the space, state and Sri Kailasha of Paramashiva. So here, let's sit straight, visualize Bhagwan in the third eye and connect to Swamiji, contemplate on these amazing truths that Swamiji has given today. Very profound and very clear how Paramashiva is in every breath of us, every action of us, every decision of us. And more Paramashiva is there, the beautiful space, less and less we are there. And more it is a celebration. The infinite possibility simply happens. How scientifically, how by Shastra, how simple lifestyle could give us all these great truths. The five actions of Paramashiva simply can happen, and our maturity happens in the five beautiful great truths. Asteya, Ahimsa, Satya, Aparigraha and Brahmacharya simply happens in us. We do not have to conclude or decide or think of all that. Simply, he makes us understand how we spiritually mature with what is happening, in spite of what is happening, and simply how he is raising us to the ultimate maturity without any effort from our side. Just celebrating Swamiji inside us makes everything possible. Now, let's connect to Swamiji in oneness again and again. Contemplate on these amazing truths, very profound, very deep, and chanta mahavakya. It's so beautiful that mahavakya leads us to the ultimate space with Paramashiva, with Swamiji. So the mahavakya gives us the opening to the higher consciousness. So let's start chanting the mahavakya. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda 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 Paramashivoham. Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda 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 Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Parama Shivoham Om Nityananda Parama Shivoham Om Nityananda Parama Shivoham Om Nityananda Parama Shivoham
Yeah.
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द
Ananda Paramashivoham Om Nityananda 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 Paramashivoham Nityananda Paramashivoham Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham Nityananda Paramashivoham Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham Nityananda Paramashivoham Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham Om
And so powerful. Swamiji himself manifesting through you. Please go ahead and check the temperature, whether you kept a solid or liquid. If you have a thermometer, you can take a picture of that. And if you have two glasses, just check the temperature. Please make sure you post these beautiful results in Sri Kailasha Kotiyad Manifesting Powers group. All the leelas of Paramashiva, any manifestation that happens, if you share it with the group, there are thousands of sharing of all these power manifestation, the jnana pada, how the powerful cognition simply manifest as powers once it becomes a cognition in you. And simply Swamiji manifest all these through us. Again and again living, Swamiji manifesting through us, each and every step of our life. We start living less of us and more Swamiji makes it happen for us. And simply we start living the beautiful life of oneness and celebration with Paramashiva. each and every step, Swamiji is manifesting his Leela, all the Leelas, how they recorded in Trivannamalai that Swamiji narrates as Atma Pramana. Here we are recording all these beautiful Leelas which you can share with the world and bring your friends and family to the satsang. How Swamiji said, we need to reach 1 billion people. The more and more we reach and we explain patiently and show all these great manifestation of Paramashiva, which is happening real in us, the more and more people are going to get healed and completed, and more celebration happens around us. So you can share the page and invite them for the satsang, invite them for the weekend program, Atmalinga program. Go ahead and share every day all these power manifestation, the greatest happening on planet Earth that Swamiji is giving us just like that. Go ahead and share all these great truths. Looking back, you'll understand how each step Swamiji has guided, explained, being patient with all our tantrums and made us manifest all these powers and our life and slowly guiding us. Even if Brahma had to experience this or Indra has to experience this, they have to experience Swamiji. They have to come to planet Earth. Probably they are all waiting and jealous of all of us, manifesting all these powers, and Swamiji simply happens through us. So share the great truth with the world. Share in this Facebook page. You can share it in your own page wall also and share it with the world. Here, a common forum where all these manifesting powers, all the Leelas, how Swamiji said, it's the pure space, zero, becomes infinity. Each of us experience Paramashiva, the infinite powers and infinite intelligence is recorded as Parashakti here. Swamiji himself manifesting through all of us to show how he is manifesting every step of our life. So go ahead and record with your powerful cognition and power manifestation. If you have photos, videos, please go ahead and share so that the rest of the billion people can also experience the great truth and start experiencing the ultimate space, state, powers and Sri Kailasha of Swamiji himself manifesting through us. All the power manifestation, whenever we manifest powers, surrender all that to Swamiji's lotus feet. The more and more the powerful cognition which excites you, more and more the power manifestation which brings you so much of confidence, so much of reality in you, surrender to Swamiji's lotus feet. The more and more we surrender, the higher and higher we mature with the powerful cognition that Swamiji is giving us. So such an amazing satsang and power manifestation. Thanking Swamiji with a deep gratitude, surrender all these power manifestation to his lotus feet. With that, visualize Bhagwan in your third eye and let's end with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamadashyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashivam Padukarpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Thank you everybody. Thank you Swamiji. See you again in the next Power Manifestation session. Nityanandam.
Thank you.